Good morning, everyone. Today we will deal with the last topic in the chapter self-analysis or know yourself. See, in the last lecture we have seen how will you know yourself, then how it will help you to understand yourself and to get rid of feelings that will affect your mind. Now we will see what is SWOT analysis. SWOT stands for strengths, weaknesses, opportunities and threats. So basically you should understand your strength, your weaknesses and opportunities you will have in future, and threats that will affect your future. So these things, SWOT, weaknesses, opportunities and threats, they are in your mind or in your capacity. So a SWOT analysis is a framework for analyzing your strength and weaknesses and the opportunities and threats you face. So you can analyze your strength and weaknesses and you will face opportunities and threats in your life. So why SWOT analysis is important? This helps you to focus on your strength, minimize your weaknesses and take the greatest possible advantage of your opportunities available. See, if you see yourself in a big picture, you will have a great opportunities in your life. And when you overcome your weaknesses, it becomes your strength. It becomes your strength. It means weaknesses can be your strength if you overcome it. And when you have strength, you will have big opportunities in your life. So let's see a chart. So this is a chart. Write it down in your notebook. See, there are internal factors, external factors, positive impact and negative impact. So what are the internal factors? Your strength is your internal factor. Your weaknesses is the internal factor. Internal factor means it is within you. It is within you. And what are the negative impacts? Weaknesses and threats. These are the negative things in your life. And what are the external factors? Opportunities and threat. It means they are external factors. You will find it outside within you. And what are the positive factors? Strength and opportunities. These are the positive factors. You should understand that internal factors include strength and weaknesses. External factors include opportunities and threats. Because opportunities and threat you will face in your life. And negative factors are weaknesses and threat. These are your negative points. And what are your positive points? Strength and opportunities. Let's see. A SWOT analysis is particularly powerful, that it can help you uncover opportunities that you can take advantage of. So if you analyze yourself, if you analyze your SWOT, when you analyze your strength, weaknesses, opportunities and threats, you will uncover great opportunities and you will get benefit from it. And by understanding your weaknesses, see, listen carefully. By understanding your weaknesses, you can manage and eliminate threats. Eliminate manje dur karne. Eliminates your threats that would otherwise put you in difficulties. See, if you have something weak point, it will definitely affect your life. And if you manage it, if you eliminate it, if you delete it, in other words, it will definitely benefit you. It means you can manage your weaknesses and you can delete your threats or eliminate your threats. See, what Cicero said, he's a great philosopher. No one can give you better advice than yourself. मराठी मध्ये एक म्हण आहे पहा, ऐकावे ऐकावे जनाचे करावे मनाचे. दिस इज द सेम थिंग. सो तुम्हाला एक चांगला सल्ला कोण देऊ शकत? येस इट्स यू. ओनली यू कॅन गिव्ह युअर सेल्फ अ प्रॉपर अडवाईस, बिकॉज ओनली यू कॅन अंडरस्टँड युअर पॉझिटिव्ह अँड निगेटिव्ह थिंग्स. नो वन एल्स. When you understand your positive and negative things, you will get a good advice in your life. So, no one can give you better advice than yourself. This is what Cicero said about life. Now, benefits of SWOT analysis. As I said, weaknesses and threats can be overcome. And it will definitely give you so much benefit. So, one of the major benefits of SWOT analysis is that it is scalable. It can be as small as a couple of people talking about a situation to a multi-month project in a large multinational company. See, you can develop your SWOT analysis in a group, so you will understand the others' strengths, others' weaknesses, others' opportunities, and others' threats. When you understand others' thought, you will get to know your thought too. See, the benefit of SWOT analysis. The point is simple. It's simple to the participants to know about your thought. They can grasp the concept and process easily. In a group, you can understand the concept and it is very easy to understand the process also. And they almost always enjoy the process. In a group, you can enjoy that process to know yourself. It can be practiced at individual or corporate level. हे तुम्ही स्वतःही करू शकता आणि कॉर्पोरेट लेवलवरती एखाद्या कंपनीच्या ठिकाणी असूनही जाऊनही तुम्ही ते करू शकता. लेस एक्सपेन्सिव्ह थॉट अनालिसिस इज व्हेरी चीप. चीप इन मीन इट मीन्स इट इज व्हेरी लेस एक्सपेन्सिव्ह. You need not to pay so much money to understand your strength, weaknesses, opportunities and threats, because it is within you. When you look at yourself, when you look at your core, you will understand your thought. A thought analysis can be done internally, provided that the internal facilitator has the experience to manage it. So the facilitator means here a teacher or a trainer. So it will give you a proper guidance, and with that guidance you can manage your thought or strength, weaknesses, opportunities and threats. Inclusive means sarvasamaveshak. It allows the participation of the team. As I said, you can develop your thought in a team or in a group. In addition, since it utilizes the whole team, the results are more likely to represent the real environments. As I said earlier, in a group you can understand others, and by understanding others you can understand yourself. So this is the benefit of a SWOT when you work in a group. Using SWOT analysis. When you use SWOT analysis, be realistic about the strength and weaknesses of you. See, some people are very shy, very timid. They don't want to share anything about their life, the experience they have faced. So, you should be very realistic to tell others your strength and weaknesses. So you should be realistic about the strength and the weaknesses which you have. You should distinguish between where you are today and where you could be in the future. तुम्ही आणखी करू शकता की तुम्ही स्वतःला पाहू शकता की मी आज कुठे आहे आणि मला उद्या किंवा मी उद्या किंवा भविष्यामध्ये मी कुठपर्यंत जाऊ शकतो. So this is your opportunities. So with your strength, you can acquire knowledge, and that knowledge will open the door of future or the opportunities. So you should distinguish between where you are today and you could be in the future. Also remember to be specific by avoiding gray areas and always analyze in relation to the actual situation. Gray areas means a dream. So you should not live in your dream, means you should not live in future. You should avoid it. You should live in present and think about the future, and you should act accordingly to acquire that future, to grab that future. So you should avoid that gray areas and always analyze in relation to the actual situation. So every situation, every condition, every experience you face in your life, it will give you something that will definitely help you to acquire the future. Finally, keep your SWOT analysis short and simple. So you should understand the simplicity. You should be so simple. You should not have a complex analysis of your own. So make it simple, short. Use it as a guide and not a prescription. Your SWOT analysis is a guide. It is not a prescription given by a doctor or given by or a rule. If you analyze your SWOT, it is your guide, not the rule you have made. Rule is a different thing and guidance is a different thing. Now, SWOT analysis greed. How will you understand, how will you come to know about your SWOT analysis? A SWOT analysis is typically created in a grid format. Grid format means in a written format, with the strength and weaknesses listed on the left. Strength and opportunities listed on the left, and weaknesses, threats on the right. So you should write your strength. You should write your weaknesses, and then you should write your opportunities and threats. Threats you will face in future, opportunities you will get in future. Strength you have in your present life, and weaknesses is in your present life. Now, question to complete the grid. Before, one Chinese said, Tao Te Ching, knowing others is intelligence, knowing yourself is wisdom. So there is a difference between intelligence and wisdom. Intelligence means आपण किती हुशार आहोत हे दाखवतो. Wisdom म्हणजे चातुर्य, तुमचे गुण. So knowing others is an intelligent thing, but when you know yourself, it is your wisdom. Mastering others is a strength. Mastering yourself is power. Mastering others is a strength. लोकांवरती कंट्रोल ठेवणं, त्यांच्यावरती एक अन्याय बाजूनं हक्क गाजवणं, ही एक तुमची ताकद आहे. बट वेन यू मास्टर युअर सेल्फ, इट इज युअर पॉवर. वंस यू शुड एक्वायर योर फिजिकल एंड मेंटल स्ट्रेंथ और मेंटल पावर. व्हेन यू एक्वायर योर फिजिकल एंड मेंटल पावर नो वन विल स्टॉप यू. सो हाउ विल यू कंप्लीट दैट ग्रीड. सो यू शुड आस्क यूर सेल्फ दीज क्वेश्चन एंड इट विल हेल्प यू टू नोट डाउन योर स्ट्रेंथ वीकनेसेस अपॉर्चुनिटीज एंड थ्रेट्स. How will you understand your strength? Ask yourself a question. What do you do well? What do you do well? What unique resources can you draw on? What do others see as your strengths? So these questions or more questions will help you to analyze your strengths. The first one is, what do you do well? What unique resources can you draw on? What do others see as your strengths? Now come to weaknesses. What could you improve? तुम्ही स्वतःमध्ये कशा प्रकारे बदल घडवू शकता कि तुम्ही स्वतःमध्ये कशा प्रकारे इम्प्रूव्हमेंट आणू शकता. Where do you have fewer resources than others? दुसऱ्यांपेक्षा तुमच्याकडे कमी कोणते असे स्त्रोत आहेत, कोणते असे पॉइंट्स आहेत हेही तुम्ही ओळखला पाहिजे. देन इट विल बिकम युअर वीकनेसेस. ऑब्विसली यू कॅन ओव्हरकम युअर वीकनेसेस. व्हॉट अदर्स लाईक यू टू सी ॲज वीकनेसेस. दुसऱ्यांच्या मते तुमचे वीकनेसेस काय आहेत हेही तुम्हाला समजून घेणं तितकंच गरजेचं आहे. नाव कम्स अपॉर्च्युनिटीज. What good opportunities are open to you? As I said earlier, where you can see yourself today or in a future. So you should understand the opportunities you have in your future life. What trends could you take advantage of? तुम्ही कोणत्या एका नियमाचा किंवा कोणत्या एका लाईनचा वापर करून तुम्ही अपॉर्च्युनिटीज, तुमची जी काही संधी आहे ती मिळवू शकता. हाऊ कॅन यू टर्न युअर स्ट्रेंथ इन टू अपॉर्च्युनिटीज. तुमच्या स्ट्रेंथचा तुम्ही अपॉर्च्युनिटीज मध्ये कसा वापर करू शकता, त्यामध्ये कशा प्रकारे बदल घडवून आणू शकता. सो व्हेन यू अंडरस्टँड युअर स्ट्रेंथ it will definitely guide you towards your opportunities. Now threats. What trends could harm you? tumhala konte badal harm karu shaktat, tyacha tras tumhala hou shakto hehi tumhi lakshat ghetle paise. otherwise it will affect you definitely. the next question, what is your competition doing? So tumhi ja sparde madhe utarlela aahe tyacha tumhala knowledge aahe ka, te tumhala kitpat bhitidayak vatte, tyamadhun tumhi kase swatala samore jau shakta, swatara swatamadhe badal ghadvun anu shakta hehi titkas mahatvacha aahe. So what is your competition doing? Now forget about this exercise. I will tell you what to do. See, I will send this PDF copy in your group so you will understand. There is nothing very much important in this chapter because this is the page of from another book and this is other book. Yes. Same thing. Know then thyself, presume not God to scan. The proper study of mankind is man. An essay on man. Knowing yourself is the beginning of all wisdom. As I said earlier, this is the same thing because I have posted this here because it will help you more. These are some questions to judge yourself. Now see, this is one figure, this is one chart. At the core, it is written self-awareness. And when you understand yourself, you will understand these. The first one is to understand your real intention. When you analyze yourself, you will analyze or you will understand your real intention, your real motive of life, to develop your own identity. When you analyze yourself, you can develop your own identity to adapt to situation. म्हणजे कोणत्याही परिस्थितीमध्ये स्वतःला बदलून घेणं, स्वतःमध्ये बदल घडवू शकणं. जसं तो एक उदाहरण देतो तुम्हाला, तुम्हाला तो रंग बदलणारा सरडा माहित असेल, कॅमोफ्लॉज म्हणतो आपण त्याला, की तो प्रत्येक स्थितीमध्ये प्रत्येक कलरमध्ये स्वतःला स्वतःमध्ये बदल घडवून आणू शकतो. म्हणजे काय की त्या रंगामध्ये तो लगेच मिक्स होतो. सो दॅट इज अडॅप्टेशन और कॅमोफ्लॉज, सायंटिफिक टर्म आहे. टू अडॅप्ट सिच्युएशन, कोणत्याही सिच्युएशन मध्ये स्वतःला अडॅप्ट करून घेणे. टू प्रोजेक्ट युअर पॉझिटिव्ह पर्सनॅलिटी, प्रोजेक्ट युअर पॉझिटिव्ह पर्सनॅलिटी बाय अनालायझिंग युअर सेल्फ वेन यू केम टू नो अबाउट युअर स्ट्रेंथ, यू कॅन प्रोजेक्ट युअर पॉझिटिव्ह पर्सनॅलिटी. To experience more conscious and successful life. These are the benefits of self-analysis. To experience more consciousness and successful life. The last one, to know your feelings and emotions. To know your feelings and emotions. So, when you analyze yourself, when you came to know about your strength, weaknesses and threats, then only you can know your feelings and emotions. So this is the importance of self-analysis or self-awareness. There is nothing more to talk about. The importance of self-analysis is assessment. Assessment means the greed we have seen in the last pages. So today I will stop here, and in the next lecture we will see a next chapter. Till then, thank you.